Hey guys, this is Dr. Sangeeta and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And today's topic is the public health topic in which we are going to cover the statistics. So today's topic is the biostatistics. So without further ado, let's get started. So guys, before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future videos. This video of biostatistics, we are going to talk about the measures of central tendency, measure of dispersion, as well as the Gaussian curve. So talking about the measures of central tendency, that means we are going to measure the value which comes in the center. So that is what the measure of central tendency is, in that we have the arithmetic mean, median, as well as mode. So mean, median, mode is a frequently asked question for exam also. How do we calculate this mean? Now, if we are talking about mean, suppose we have values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Suppose we have these values. See, if I want to calculate the mean, that means I'm going to add all these values and divide it by. So I'm going to sum of all values divided by total number of values. So that is going to be 1 plus 2 plus 3 plus 4 plus 5 plus 6 plus 7 plus 8 divided by, because we have total number of values 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So we have total number of values which is 8. So that is going to be 36 divided by 8, which will come around 4.5. So the mean for this is 4.5. So this is the mean. Mean, arithmetic mean, is sum of all the values and then divide the values by the total number. See, the main advantage of calculating or using the arithmetic mean is that it is easy to understand and it is based on all the observations. But the disadvantage is that it is extremely affected by the extreme values. So that we are going to talk about once we complete the mean, median, mode. But if the observation, or suppose if any of the observational value is missing by chance, then also we cannot calculate the mean, right? So that is also one of the disadvantage. Next, coming to the median. So the median is, the first of all, in the median, what we are going to do, we are going to arrange, suppose I have value, I have a value of 2, 1, 5, 4 and 3. Okay, these are the values I have. So in order to calculate the median, I have to first arrange them in the ascending or descending order. And then I have to take the middle value. So I'll be doing 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So my median is going to be 3, because 3 is the middle value. This is when the odd number are present. What happens when instead of up till 5, it is 6? Then what is going to be the median? Then we are going to take middle two values and we are going to calculate the mean of middle two values. So that is going to be 3 plus 4 divided by 2. So that is going to be 3.5. So this is our median. So median is, we are first arranging the data in ascending or descending order and we are taking the middle value. In case if data is present in even number, then we are going to take mean of the two values. So the advantage of calculating median is, again, understand, easy to calculate, and it is not affected by the extreme values. But the disadvantage is that it is not based on all the observations. Then we have the mode. So coming to mode. Mode is most frequently occurring value in the observation. Suppose if I'm talking about 2, 3, 3, 5, 8, 10. then the value which is most frequently occurring, which is most repeated, is our mode. So in this case, mode is going to be 3, right? What happens? Mode is going to be 3. What happens when there are two frequently occurring values? Suppose in this case, I have 5, 5, 8. Now what will happen? We have two 3s and we have two 5s. Now in this case, mode is going to be 3 median. That means 3 into median minus 2 into mode. So if we calculate median for this, so median for this is going to be 5, right? So in this value, median for this is going to be, see, median is 1 1 1 1 1 1 1 1, and then this is our median, the middle value, right? So this is 3 into 5 minus 2 into mode. So our mode is 2 into mean. So the mean value is, so the mean is 2 plus 3 plus 3 plus 5 plus 5 plus 8 plus 10 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 divided by 7. So this value will come around. So I'm going to just calculate this value. So 3 into 5, so this is going to be 5 is median and mean is our 5.14. I have calculated it. So this is mode. So mode will come 15 minus 10.3 somewhere. So that will come around 4.7. So this is our mode. Now I hope that you guys are clear with the mean, median, mode. So mode is the most frequently occurring value in the observation. What happens when there is more than one frequently occurring value? Then we take the formula 3 into median minus 2 into mean. So that is our measures of central tendency. Now that we talk about the measures of dispersion. So before talking about measures of dispersion, let's see why are we studying this measure of dispersion. See, this is very important to understand. Suppose if I have value of 2, 5, 5, 10, and then after this value have 1000. So I'm going to have one extreme value, right, in this case. Now this extreme value, actually we call it the outlier. So this is outlier. So this is out of the box, right? So this value is all of a sudden out of the box. So in this case, if we calculate mean, then mean is going to be 2 plus 5 plus 5 plus 10 plus 1000 divided by 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. In this case, median is going to be 1, 1, 1, 1, and then this 5. Then mode is going to be the frequently occurring, which is the 5. Now, if we calculate mean, it will come 204.4. Okay, so mean is absolutely not a reliable. We can see that. This is the least reliable. So the value which is affected most by this extreme value, or we can say by this outlier, which is going to be mean. So we cannot take this mean into consideration. Then the least affected value is going to be the mode, right? Because this value is the most frequently occurring. So this is going to be the least affected. Then the most reliable out of this measure of central tendency is going to be our median. Then, and this is the reason how much it is deviated. See, measure of dispersion means how far we are going from the central value. So from mean, median, mode, suppose if we have values like this. So from the center, which is the 5, from the center, how extreme we are going, how much values are dispersed, how values are scattered, that we are going to read in the measures of dispersion. So the first one is the range. Range means, I could have taken that example only. So range is 2, 5, 5. Then again we are taking that example. 1000. So range is the difference between the lowest and the highest. So highest and the lowest. So difference between the highest and the lowest is going to be, we can say this value ranges from 1 to 1000. As you have seen, excuse me, as you have seen, once we are telling any data, so what do we tell? We tell that it has a range of 2 to 1000, right? Or we can tell the difference. So we can calculate this 1000 minus 2, right? So this is going to be again the range. See, this is the simplest method to check the measure of variability, or we can say the measure of dispersion, one and the same thing. Then comes the mean deviation. So mean deviation, or I'm going to write just MD. Mean deviation is equal to, this is the constant, okay? Then we have x minus x bar. So what is our x and what is our x bar, divided by n. N is the total number. Suppose I'm giving to you an example. See, this is the average of the deviation from the mean. Mean deviation is how much this value is deviated from the mean. See, suppose mean is 5 and the value is 2. So how it is deviated from the mean. So that is what we are going to calculate. How are we going to calculate? We have a formula. So this x minus x bar divided by, so x is what? X is our each value we are going to talk about. X bar is what? X bar is our mean. And then value is our number of values. So we are going to just take example. Suppose it is 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50, right? So in this case, this is going to be, see, we are not taking constant in consideration. So x is our, we are going to first see each value, right? So each value is, so we are going to calculate the difference first and then we will divide it by n. So the first difference is 10 minus, so first we need to calculate the mean, right? X bar. X bar is going to be 10 plus 20 plus 30 plus 40 plus 50 divided by 5. So that is going to be 25, right? Mean is going to be 25 for this. Well, I'm sorry guys, this is 150 divided by 5. So that will come 30. So X bar, our mean is the 30. Okay, I'm going to write it here. X bar is 30. Now, what we are going to do? We are going to subtract this from each value. So each value is 10 minus 30, then 20 minus 30, then 30 minus 30. So then we have 40 minus 30, then we have 50 minus 30, right? Right. So now we are not considering minus in consideration. So the 10 minus 30 is going to be 20, right? Then it is going to be 10, then it is going to be 0, then again it is going to be plus 10, then again it is going to be plus 20. I am not considering again minus, we are not considering minus. Now we are going to add all these. So 20, 30, then 30, 30, 60, we have 60. So x minus x bar is our 60 divided by total number of values. How many values we have? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So this is going to be 60 divided by 5, which is our 12. So the mean deviation is 12. So we are telling that from every value there is a deviation of 12 from the mean value. So this is the mean deviation. Then we talk about, you have to remember the formula. So I'm just writing here the formula. X minus x bar divided by n. Then comes the standard deviation. So the formula for standard deviation is, again we have sigma as a constant, but here, see, but here the difference is that we have the square root. In mean deviation there was no square root. So the standard deviation is again sigma into x minus x bar, that square. Now earlier we had x minus x bar divided by just n. Now the square root of, mean deviation we are talking, right? So the standard deviation is, now you can see, you can make out from the formula itself. So standard deviation is basically this whole value, is the mean, right? So this is square root, this is square root of mean deviation. Okay, then we are going to again take the same example and we are going to check the calculations, how much the standard deviation comes. So see, now this is when the value is more than 30. What if the value is less than 30? This also we need to see. If the value is less than 30, then we have n minus 1. Okay, now if we are taking the same example, if we are taking 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, again the same thing. But we have only 5 values, right? So we are going to take n minus 1 in this. Now the standard deviation, first of all we need to calculate the mean deviation, right? So for mean deviation, the mean was 30, right? We are going to take the mean as previously we have calculated. So the mean was again 30. Now what we are doing? We are subtracting this. So this is going to be 10 minus 30, 20 minus 30, 30 minus 30, 40 minus 30, and then we are going to do 50 minus 30. Now that we have values, minus 20, minus 10, 0, plus 10, plus 20. So we are going to again remove the minus part. Now we are going to do the square. As you can see, we have to do the square, right, in the formula. So we are doing the square of each. So square of each, that will come. So 20 into 20, how much it will be? 400. 10 into 10, how much it will be? 100. Then we have again 10 into 10, 100. 20 into 20, 400. So 500 plus 500, we have got 1000. Right? So now what we need to do? Now we have this value. Now we have to divide it by n minus 1. So the 1000 divided by n is how much? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So we have to do 5 minus 1, that will equal to 4. So we have to do 1000 divided by 4. So guys, the value comes 250, right? Now this is the standard deviation. Next comes the coefficient of variance. What is coefficient of variance? This is standard deviation. Again, we are using the previous formula, whatever formula we are calculating. So standard deviation is equal to square of mean deviation and square root of that, right? So this is our mean deviation. If the value is, again, if the value is more than 30, if the value is less than 30, then we have to do n minus 1. Now comes the coefficient of variance. Now this coefficient of variance has no unit, so it is used to compare the variability. So coefficient of variance is equal to standard deviation divided by mean into 100. Now you know that how to calculate the standard deviation. Also you know that how to calculate the mean. So we are not going to do the calculation for this. So coefficient of variance is standard deviation divided by mean into 100. Right? So this is our, we can say CV or COV, coefficient of variation. Now comes the Gaussian curve. So Gaussian curve is basically, as the name suggests, it is a curve, right? It is a curve. Actually, it is a bell-shaped curve, I must say. So bell-shaped curve, which is bilateral symmetrical. So if we look at both sides of this curve, it will be going to have the same values on either side. That means, suppose if here is x, then here is going to be x, then if here is going to be y, then here is going to be also y, then here is going to be z, then here is going to be z. So the distance between is going to be equal between the values. So this Gaussian curve is seen when there is bell-shaped curve. Okay, first of all, bilateral symmetrical. When there is mean is equal to median is equal to mode. So when the mean median mode comes in the center of this bell shaped curve, bilateral symmetrical, when the mean is equal to median is equal to mode, then this is a normal distribution curve, or we can say the Gaussian curve. So if we are calculating the mean in this, so the mean for this is going to be, if we are talking about till up till x, so if we are taking only one standard deviation, see this is deviation from the mean, right? So this is going to be the one standard deviation, then this is going to be the two standard deviation. So deviated, two values deviated from the mean, then we have the three standard deviation, right? So mean for one standard deviation is going to be mean plus minus, so mean plus minus one standard deviation if we are talking about, that means how much it is deviated from only one standard deviation, then this is going to be 68% of the curve, 68.3% if we talk about exactly. If we are taking mean plus minus two standard deviation, that means if we are talking about graph up till here, up till y, then see it covers lot of graph, right? Then of course it is going to be higher than the one standard deviation, then it is going to be 95.4%. Then if we are talking about up till z, now you can see up till z it almost cover whole of the graph. So the mean plus minus three standard deviation is going to be 99.7%. Now you know that if we are talking about deviation at the Gaussian curve, at the normal distribution curve, so from the mean, from the we can say mean median mode is equal in this, right? So from the mean, how much it is deviated from either one value, so it is going to be 68% of this curve. Then if we are talking about two standard deviation, then it is going to be 95.4 value. If it is three standard deviation, that means it cover almost whole of this curve, that is our 99.7%. So this is, guys, the normal distribution curve or the Gaussian curve. Also we have the skewness of the graph, so it can be the either positive or it can be either the negative skewness. See, coming to the skewness of the curve, if this curve is shifted, this is the mean value, right? You remember the mean value. So if this curve is shifted to right, instead of this, if this curve is shifting to the right side, then it is a, because see, always remember that the right is always positive, right? So it is the positive skewness of the curve. Remember this, remember like this. Then if there is a positive skewness of the curve, that means the mean is greater than the median, and is median is greater than the mode. So the mean is the highest if there is a positive skewness of the curve. If the curve is shifted to the left side, if the curve is shifted to the left side, then that means this is a negative skewness of the curve. But to remember this, remember that right is always positive. Positive is always right. So that means if the positive skewness positive, that means that this is the right side shift of the curve. Now if the curve is left, that means the mean is less. Mean is less than the median, is less than the mode. If there is positive skewness, that means the mean is greater than the median, than the mode. So this is going to be positive and the negative skewness of the graph. So guys, this is about the measures of central tendency, measure of variance, or we can say the measures of dispersion, how much the dispersion is. So this is about the mean median mode and the measures of dispersion. And if you have enjoyed the video, then give it a thumbs up, and you can also comment in the comment section below. And guys, in the description box, now you have a chance to support me on Paytm as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys. and to make free notes. So guys, till then, take care. Bye-bye. Keep reading, keep learning. I will see you soon.